TechRam here. So the idea with this video is to do a triple OS install try. So I have some, let's see if I can get another picture. Some USB drives. And each of them contains an operating system. And we're gonna give it a try and see how many of them we can actually successfully install. So I mean, this isn't an installation tutorial, this is just to prove a point that what one can install on a relatively old hardware and still have it working. So anyway, let's start with Ubuntu. So this is the, at the time of video taking, this is the latest desktop version. Wants to change the input signal version. So let's get started and let's hope I've selected the correct boot drive on the hard drive side so it'll install onto the correct hard drive. Let's see what happens. Oh, there's something got wrong with the colors. Cable loose. It is really wrong. It's not the camera's fault, but that's reality. I wonder if I pulled out the HDMI cable by mistake. Thank you. color changes. That color problem is really weird. No, it's still there. That is very strange. It's like a cable fault or now the colors are okay. Is that the default installation color? Because this is the background. But that won't see. Seems to be working. Now it's installing updates. So we've proven that we can install Ubuntu on this machine without too much trouble. So, Windows 10 Pro. Sometimes difficult to scroll. Yep, that looks good. Let's see, we should be able to select drive, I hope. Should be able to install it as a pro app. And then that was without media stuff. Depending on what license you have. Don't think it matters. So accept it. Next. Custom. No. Oh, you can't see the drive names. That sucks. So how do I know? Kirish, I guess. I mean, that's probably the one drive on the motherboard. That one's unallocated. And then those are already assigned, so those must be the Ubuntu installation. So this must be the assist. Okay, let's take that one. So, I will do it. Used the right mouse. Anyway, Windows 10 Pro. What can I say? I've seen this before. Nothing amazing. So anyway, so that's been proven. So we can install Ubuntu and we can install Windows 10 Pro. Yep. And then we take it with. Okay, that looked a bit different. I hope I'm actually starting the installer. It doesn't jump too long. This actually, I will see if it ends up in the installer or in the Ubuntu installation. Thank you. Okay, did we get rid of the color problem? Yes, we did. So it's the opposite to what they've had online. So on the online comments it says don't use UEFI BIOS support because you'll end up with the pink problem. And here's actually, it's actually the opposite. So you have to use the UEFI BIOS support to get the correct. But it didn't seem to have any effect on the installation, as far as I could see. And Ubuntu starts just fine, so. Yeah. Technology for.